In that video, you are going to discover how to apply advanced encryption standard algorithm Android with Android Studio. The advanced encryption standard, also known by its original name RingeDAL, is a specification for the encryption of electronic data established by the US National Institute of Standards and Technology in 2001. First, we are going to create the user interface of our application. The main layout will have an edit text to enter the text to encrypt, another edit text to enter the password used to encrypt the text, the text view to display the encrypted text, the first button used to start the encryption process, and the second button used to start the decryption process. On the right of the screen, you can see the preview of the user interface. In the main activity of our application, we are going to write the Java code. First, we define properties to store references of the views. For both input text and for the text view, and also for both buttons. In the onCreate method, we get references of the views. We set an unclick listener on the encrypt button. When the user will click on it, we'll get the text and the password entered, and then we will call the encrypt method. Create the encrypt method used to encrypt the data using the given password. First, we get the generated key by calling the generate key method. We create the generate key method. The generate key method will be used to generate the secret key using the given password. We use message digest class to get instance of the SHA-256 algorithm used to generate the key. We convert the password into byte array with an UTF-8 encoding. We update the digest using the specified array of bytes, starting at the specified offset. We complete the hash computation by performing final operations such as padding. We build a secret key from the given byte array. And finally, we return the secret key. We create a cipher instance from cipher class with the advanced encryption standard algorithm. We initialize the cipher, which is encrypted mode, with a key. We encrypt data in a single part operation. Then we convert the byte array into string before to return the encrypted value. When the text is encrypted, we display the result in the output text by calling the setText method. We try our application. We enter a text to encrypt. And we enter a password, and we can click on the encrypt button to encrypt the text and see the result. You can see the encrypted text. Now we are going to write the code for the decrypted process. We set an onclick listener on the encrypt button. When the user will click on it, we'll get the text to decrypt and the password to use. Then we will call the decrypt method. We create the decrypt method. The decrypt method will be used to decrypt a text passed in parameter with the password entered. First, we get the generated key by calling the generateKey method. Then we create a cipher instance from cipher class with the advanced encryption standard algorithm parameter. We initialize the cipher with the decrypted mode and the key in parameter. We decode the encrypted string and return as a byte array. We decrypt data in a single part operation. And we convert the byte array into a string. Now it's time to run our application on the Android emulator to test the decrypt method. So we enter a password, a text, and we click on the encrypt button and we can click on the decrypt button to see the result. If we change the password, if the decryption process has an exception, we are going to display a wrong password message. So, we are going to encrypt the text, change the password, and try to decrypt the text to see if the error is well displayed. That's all for the tutorial made by Tamil for the Astorel channel. Note that you can also send me your ID for new tutorials and collaborate with me on the channel. Contact me by email for further details.